Well, hello, Bishop Patrick L. Wooden Sr. here, pastor of the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. I pray that you're having a fantastic day. As you can see, I'm not at my desk today. I'm actually in the sanctuary. I'm sure you recognize it. And the reason I'm in here today broadcasting to you is because a wonderful change is about to take place, and I want to talk to you about it. But before I go there, I want to ask you a question. Has there ever been a greater time to be a Christian? Look at all of the things that are taking place in our world today. Upheaval, unrest, oh my, all kinds of things. We're inundated with COVID-19. We're given bad news. We talk about, when you turn the television on, you can't get away from the increase in the amount of cases of people who've got COVID and this, that, and the other. There are the presidential elections going on. There are the gubernatorial elections. There are the commercials. People slinging mud left and right. All this stuff is going on. Well, guess what? Guess what? The God of the Bible is still on the throne. He's still high and lifted up. And the whole world is filled with his glory. And I'm grateful today to know that the God of the Bible is real and he's a keeper. And for you out there, maybe I haven't mentioned anything that's on your mind. Maybe you're going through something personal. Maybe there's a sick loved one. Oh, my. Maybe there's a financial problem. Maybe your business was one of the businesses that they've shut down due to the COVID-19 response. Well, I want you to know you're in the hands of the God of the Bible. And I'll say to you, as I said to one of my dear friends today in the Lord, God promised that his rod and his staff would comfort you. The rod and staff of the God of the Bible, the God whom David declared is my shepherd, that God is with you. And that mighty God, the only true God, the God of gods, the King of kings, is alive and well, and he's doing some marvelous things in the earth and here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. Tonight's service will be a powerful service indeed. The Lord has visited me and given me a word that is so important that I want to share with you. But after I share the word, I want you to come and come on time. We will be giving a presentation. We've sent out some information already with the constant contacts. We will be giving our layout on what we're about to do. The God of the Bible has let me know that now is the time to move to a 8 a.m. service to accommodate the saints as a result of the social distancing requirements and the things that we're doing to keep us safe. We've now been 11 weeks back. We haven't had one COVID-related case that has generated from worshiping here at the sanctuary, because we do, my friends, take the virus seriously. We do know that it is real. We're not in a state of denial, but we do believe in worshiping the God of the Bible in the sanctuary, gathering, praise the Lord, as the Bible has said, assembling is a part of our worship. And God has kept us safe. He's kept me safe. He's kept my wife. He's kept my children and my grandchildren. He's kept my soon to be 85 years old. If she lived to see the end of August, my mom will be 85, and yet she is amongst the mothers here who comes to church and who worships the Lord, and God is watching over all of us and he's keeping us safe. But let me tell you, people have been coming from miles around, from as far south as Macon, Georgia, from as far north as Richmond, Virginia, and all in between. People driving from Charlotte, people driving in from here and there. We're hearing from people all over, and God is blessing. And the Lord says now is the time, and we're going to move to a 8 a.m. service. And we took our time in making the transition so that we could make the transition and be safe and be wise and make sure all of the protocols are in place so that we will do as much as we can do to keep people safe from this dreaded COVID-19 pandemic that has swept the world. But I tell you, we serve a God who's a God in the midst of a pandemic. I've never read a scripture that has an asterisk beside it that says, oh, except in the cases of COVID-19. I found out that the God we serve is a present help in trouble. And I'm thankful that the Lord is watching over us. And I want you to come tonight to hear for yourself the plans. And we want to announce that at 8 a.m. this coming Sunday morning, we will be having our first 8 a.m. worship service at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. We've resisted doing that for years, but the Lord says now is the time, and we will have our 11 a.m. service, and it will go on as scheduled. And there's going to be some churching going on in here. Also, I would like to tell you that this Saturday, our very first graduation class, the very first graduation class of the North Carolina Third Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction Academy will take place right here. Much of it will be virtual, and I am going to give the address. God's given me a word to share with the graduates. I'm so excited about it. And I want to congratulate all of the graduates. I want to congratulate Dr. Yvonne Watford McKinney, our dean. She's amazing. And all who worked with our school. Thank God for every one of these powerful, powerful workers. Thank you, Sister Mary Williams, Evangelist Williams, for the job that you're doing. And so many good things are taking place right here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. The God who is the God of the universe, the God who is looking for someone to show himself strong on their behalf. That God is moving here. And my friends, he's right where you are. And he's moving, and he loves you, and he's concerned about you, as am I. Come out tonight and hear the word of the Lord. Come out tonight and hear the instructions and the protocols and the things that we're going to explain and show tonight, so that you will see that we're moving, and we're moving safely, we're moving responsibly, we're moving properly. But we're moving. See, when it comes to God, God will give you a way to do whatever needs to be done. If we just have the desire to obey, I found out that if I have the desire and the mind to obey, God will make a way. He'll make it possible for me to obey him and to carry out his commands. I'll see you tonight right here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ for Bible study. Yeah, we're going to study the Bible together. And I'm telling you, the scriptures are going to bless you real good. I'll see you here.